The new and exciting DAX calendar-based time intelligence functionality is here. And the big question is this a big deal? Is it mind-blowing? Or is it just meh? Well, as it turns out, for one group of people, this is going to be completely mind-blowing. For the rest of us, it's probably more of a nice to have right now. Let's find out which group you belong to. First of all, calendar tables and time intelligence are nothing new. We've been doing this for more than a decade now. If you want to get started with that, go to learnpowerbi.com/calendar and grab my easy to use copy and paste ultimate calendar template that will unlock all the time intelligence magic for you. So what exactly is new then? Before we get to that, let's talk about the three kinds of calendars that exist. Regular calendar, also called Gregorian calendar, the one we all know, starts on January 1, ends on December 31. Fiscal calendar, the start of the year gets shifted. For example, when I worked at Microsoft, our fiscal year started on July 1. Custom calendars, now these can get truly exotic. Retail calendars are a classic example. They often use a 4-week, 5-week, 4-week pattern. And here's the key difference. While regular and fiscal calendars agree on the definition of the month, for example, March is still March 1st to March 31st. But custom calendars, March can be March 2nd to April 5th. Now, let's look at the actual feature. What this lets you do is define multiple kinds of calendars within your single calendar table. And let me emphasize that. Please don't create copies of your calendar table. This is one of the biggest mistakes I see Power BI rookies make. Don't be that person. You generally only need one calendar table connected to all your data tables, even if you have multiple date fields or multiple calendar types. With this new feature, you can go into calendar options for that one calendar table and define your different calendars within. Regular, fiscal, or custom, all in one place. For example, you can define your Gregorian calendar with year, month, and so on. You can define your fiscal calendar using fiscal year, fiscal quarter, fiscal month columns. And you can define custom retail calendar using its own columns. And this could completely change how you write DAX time intelligence functions. Before, for regular calendars, you would write something like dates YTD calendar date. For fiscal calendars, you could add an optional parameter to specify the end of the fiscal year. So dates YTD calendar date, and then 6/30 as the end of fiscal year. But for custom calendars, things got messy. You needed complex DAX patterns. Here's how you could write the dates YTD equivalent. Other time intelligence functions were often equally complex. And I'll admit, even I had to look it up in my own book every time I needed to write one. And now, with this new feature, all that goes away. You can simply say dates YTD, regular calendar, fiscal calendar, or retail calendar. And that's it. No more complicated DAX. It's clean, readable, and it just works. So here's what I recommend. Step one, whether you switch to the new calendar-based time intelligence or keep using the classic time intelligence, you still need a calendar table. So go to learnpowerbi.com/calendar and grab my easy-to-use copy and paste ultimate calendar table. Then, if you're using custom calendars like retail, this feature is a big deal. So consider using this right away for any new models you build. And you can gradually update your older existing models. For everyone else using regular or fiscal calendars, you don't have to change your existing models, but start using this for new models going forward. Why? Two reasons. It's elegant. Come on, it just looks nicer. And it is future-proof. Microsoft may release new functionality that would only work with calendar-based time intelligence. For example, the new total week-to-date function. If you have any Power BI questions, just message me on LinkedIn, YouTube, or email. I'll see you in the next one. Take care and power on.